Chad?
Tetra!
Hi. Look, I had a really rough night last night, and I just needed to talk to someone.
Ah, you had another nightmare?
Yes, about the same thing.
Which was?
The hooded demon.
Oh, yeah. Chasing you again, huh?
Yeah.
Well, how did you get away this time?
I woke myself up.
That is incredible, Tetra. You're the only person I know who can literally pull her eyes open when she wants to leave a dream. That's just incredible. How do you do it?
Oh, it's kind of stupid.
Oh, come on, Tetra.
You really want to know?
Of course.
Well, ever since I was about 6, in all my dreams I've been wearing a special amulet.
Yeah?
Well, it's magical. And when I concentrate really hard, say a magic word, I can literally pull my eyes open.
That's it?
That's it.
Oh, well, I thought you were going to tell me something I could use.
No, it only works for me.
Hmm, too bad. Well, what about this demon of yours?
I guess I really don't want to talk about it anymore.
You sure? You might feel better if you told me about it.
No, maybe later.
Are you sure?
Yeah, pretty sure. Hey, listen, what did you and your brother do yesterday?
Oh, well, that's an interesting story.
Time to tell it.
Besides, you'd probably wake up before we actually finish.
Let's get her.
Ah! Get off me! We're gonna sleep!
Shut up, like you're gonna get away anyway. Ah!
Yeah, Zill, show her what's up.
That's right. Yourself, Griffin. You're lucky you got the drop on us.
Why is that?
Because if you hadn't, I would have Nike blasted your ass all over Dream World.
You cocky, arrogant son of a... Why don't you run home to Wind Dragon? He'll have a more appropriate way of dealing with you than I will.
You weak-minded, stupid...
Take off. Who was that, Clyde?
Don't know. Never seen her before.
New recruit, maybe?
Doesn't matter anymore. You dusted him off. One shot.
You're right. Practice sure does pay off.
Yep.
Oh, you all right? Look, I understand that you probably have a lot of questions right now, but we can't answer them here. It's not safe. Come on, we gotta go before our adversaries get back.
Trust me.
All right.
Great. Name's Brent, and you are?
Tetra.
All right, Tetra. Now listen closely. Our safe haven is a forest, so grab that little chess piece of yours and picture a woodland setting.
The Griffin Woods.
I've never dreamt about anything like this before.
Probably not, considering the fact that it's not your dream.
What?
Trust me. That little chess piece you've got there. It allows you to move through other people's dreams.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
Then whose dream is this?
I'll take you to meet him.
This has got to be the strangest dream I've ever had.
You think your mind is creating all of this?
All this and you.
I thought the same thing when I first got here.
Oh, really?
Really? Come on, you'll see.
Whatever. Where'd your friend go?
Oh, he probably ended up in another section of the woods. Come on now, we better check in.
Check in? What do you mean check in?
I say, what should you do in the streets of the town?
No, wait, what's that good-looking secretary in there?
Yeah, she was. But I
said, Donald, are you all right?
Yeah, what happened to you, buddy?
The Griffins got me.
So, I think
you're right.
Yeah,
you're
right. I slapped them, yes,
okay? Wind Dragon.
I don't need to resort to violence to get my point across. Do I?
No.
Good. There's a pawn missing from my chessboard.
I know.
Why is that?
A couple of griffins got the drop on us.
That's the result. Not the cause. Why did it happen, Zill?
I don't know.
You weren't fast enough. You spent too much time talking. And as a result, the Silver Dragons are forfeit a player. This is a war, Zill. Do your talking here, not on the battlefield.
Yes, sir.
Reflect on that when you wake up.
Okay.
And one last thing.
Yes, sir.
Did you see the medallion she was wearing?
Yes, sir.
Do you know what it does?
No, sir.
Neither do I. But I don't like it.
Wow.
You like it?
Yeah.
Tetra, welcome to the home of the Golden Griffons. That guy over there is the guy in charge.
This is his dream?
Yeah, his name's Kyle Zephyr.
Zephyr?
Uh-huh.
I like it.
Kyle, I'd like you to meet somebody. This is Tetra Gigan.
Kyle Zephyr, it's good to have you. We've already met Brent and Clyde, and Amphess is over there.
Just call me Amy.
As you can see, we're fairly short of manpower. You joined us just in time.
Joined you?
I don't have time to explain our position here, Tetra. Suffice it to say, we're at war. Our enemies, the Silver Dragons, come closer to discovering our whereabouts every day.
Now, wait just a minute. I'm not taking part in any war. This is none of my business.
It's your business now.
That golden chess piece you have there is your draft notice. Brent, fill her in.
No, I didn't ask to be involved in anything.
None of us did, Tetra. The chess pieces do all the choosing. They're the ones who decide who's in, not us.
You mean this little figurine made the conscious decision to drag me into a war?
Basically, yeah.
Why me? Why did it have to choose me?
Couldn't tell you that. Destiny, maybe. None of us know.
And I suppose I can't get rid of it.
The pieces inside us sort of want to enter this battle. It gives us a purpose to join together and battle our adversaries together. In another night, you won't want to get rid of it.
In another night? Brent, I've already convinced myself this is all just a dream I'm having.
It is a dream, but it's not yours. It's Kyle's. You, me, and everyone else in this forest are asleep right now. But our minds are not in our own dreams. They're in his.
Unbelievable. Well, if we are in Kyle's dream, then what happens to us when he wakes up?
Kyle isn't waking up. He's in a coma. This dream will last for a long time.
Then in that case, I can come back here tomorrow night, correct?
I would suggest it.
You would?
I would. This grove here shields you from the eyes of our enemies. Chances are, if you're not in this forest, they'll be watching.
You look troubled.
I am troubled.
It's that new girl the Griffins have, isn't it?
No, it's the amulet she's wearing.
Have you found out what it does?
No.
But it's dangerous. Very dangerous.
So who are you fighting?
Well, they call themselves the Silver Dragons.
Why are you fighting?
Everybody on our team has a golden chess piece. And everybody on the Dragons has a silver chess piece. Gold versus silver. The two opposing sides of a chess match.
That's it?
Yeah.
That's stupid.
How do you mean?
How do I mean? It's senseless. People are getting killed over a stupid game of chess.
Who said anything about killing?
Your friend shot someone through the head tonight.
You mean the guy who tried to get you tonight?
Yes.
No, no, no. He didn't die. He's, been excluded from the conflict. He's probably lying awake in bed right now trying to remember what he's been dreaming about the past 2 weeks. He's forgotten about the war completely.
You mean he's not dead?
Nope. But don't think about shooting yourself with your blaster there, because if you pull the trigger, the beam won't affect you. And as for asking a silver dragon to take you out, well, let's just say you wouldn't enjoy what they do to you first.
Hmm. No way out, huh?
Nope. We fight until another piece takes.
Well, if we're all game pieces, then who's playing us?
The two kings, Kyle Zephyr and the Wind Dragon.
The Wind Dragon?
Uh-huh. Leader of the Silver Dragons.
Is he any good?
His tactical senses are second to none. He's lived through 3 Griffin kings, and he's taken at least 30 other Griffins out of action himself. He's powerful and practically undefeatable.
Can Kyle best him?
I don't know. Kyle's good. He knows the game. But Wind Dragon's just too clever. He second-guessed almost every move Kyle's made. Kyle's one of the greatest players I've ever met. But I've seen the Wind Dragon in action. Only once, but, once was enough. We've got our work cut out for us.
Weird dream.
You all right?
Yeah.
Well, well, you can sure conjure up some pretty frightening things.
Yeah, I guess so.
Say, Tetra.
Yeah.
Why didn't you use your blaster?
I didn't know.
You may want to try using that next time.
Yeah.
Ah, Tetra, you're back. Good to see you. Wait a minute. You were wearing that medallion last night.
Yeah?
People usually don't wear jewelry two nights in a row.
I know.
So how's it you've worn that medallion in two consecutive dreams?
I've been wearing it since I was six. With it, I'm able to wake myself up.
Wake yourself up?
Pretty weird, huh?
Rare is more like it. Few people have the ability to wake themselves up with a word. The chance of having that power is very slim. Wait, that's it. You could turn this whole thing around, Tetra. I need to get a message to Wind Dragon.
What's going on, Kyle?
So simple. Challenge the dragons to a showdown, hold it in Tetra's dream. When they show up, we leave, and she wakes up. They'll wake up and remember nothing of the war.
Incredible.
It's flawless. We'll wipe the board clean. Tetra, you're a godsend. Brent, I need you to deliver a message.
Tomorrow night, you make the final move. You know, Tetra, I can't believe it. You've only been here two nights and you've already solved all our problems.
Never been a hero before.
Well, you are now. Amazing.
I wish I could tell my boyfriend about all this.
Boyfriend?
Yeah, my boyfriend, Chad.
Would he be asleep right now?
Most likely.
You could visit him in his dream.
Oh, wow, I never thought about that. I can't wait to see what he'll say.
That all depends on how you appear to him.
What's that supposed to mean?
Well, by changing your form, you can appear to him in a beautiful prom dress, or you can appear as somebody else. Yeah, you can do that in somebody else's dream, you know.
Well, I've seen him talking to Heather Johnson quite a bit lately.
Who?
Heather Johnson, president of the student council. Neighborhood, so I thought I'd drop by.
Oh, please, make yourself at home.
You've got a nice room.
Well, it's kind of dirty, you know, but I just...
Chad, I actually did come here for a reason.
Which was,
You see, my parents are going out of town tomorrow night, and I was wondering if maybe you'd like to, you know, come over and keep me company?
well, sure. Yeah.
Great. Oh, but wait, aren't you seeing that little Tetra girl?
Tetra? Oh, Tetra. Yeah, well, she's really more of an appetizer, really, than anything else. I've been dating her just to pass the time away. You see, all the while I've been looking at you. This may sound kind of stupid, but... See, ever since I met you, I've just been deeply and wholeheartedly in love with you.
Oh, really?
Really.
Well, I'm glad you told me when you did.
Well, I wouldn't want to mislead you.
Oh! I would hope not.
How? What was that for? Tetra?
Don't ever speak to me again, you bastard.
Attention. Get Steve and Damien in here immediately.
Sorry about that.
Not your fault. I'm glad I found out about it when I did.
Tetra, look,
Never mind. I just think I'd like to walk alone for a while.
Oh, good job, Brent. You can change into somebody else.
He knows the girl. He may know something about the amulet. Interrogate him. Don't eat him.
I
say, look, guys, I don't want any trouble.
So I'm sitting there, you know, and they're walking up to me like they're going to do something. One of them pulls a knife.
That's my job. I'm his head runner.
Why do you have to send Damien and Steve? I mean, Damien's never done this before, and Steve. God, Steve drools on himself and gurgles every time he tries to tie his shoes. I mean, why do you have to send them?
Maybe it's because you screwed up the last mission.
Hey, shut up, all right?
You can't expect to be the boss's pet every time you mess up.
I said shut up!
That's enough. You can't expect to defeat the Griffins when we're fighting amongst ourselves. Now knock it off.
Ask you a few questions.
She has the mental ability to wake herself up on her own. I think the medallion's just a focusing point for that ability. Like Dumbo's magic feather.
Well done, both of you. You have an interesting ace up your sleeve, Zephyr. But how will you use it?
Goddamn tyrant. It wasn't my fault. Next Griffin I see is gonna regret that he ever set foot in the same dream as Zill.
You're right. I regret it. Here's a message for your intrepid leader. See that he gets it.
I'll get you, Brent.
Sure you will.
You'll curse the night I get hold of you.
Uh-huh.
God, I hate him.
He was lucky I was merciful. Yeah, see, I had him at point-blank range. Were I in a bad mood, I probably would have dusted him, but, seeing as I wasn't, I decided I'd spare his life.
Indeed.
At any rate, he told me to give you this.
Ah, I see Zephyr's learned to make telepathy orbs.
Well, what do you think he wants to talk about?
I wonder.
Ah, Wind Dragon. It's me, your arch-nemesis.
I have not the time nor the patience to listen to your rambling, Zephyr. What is it?
Are you familiar with Norse legend?
Why?
Well, the Vikings used to believe that at the end of reality, the gods and the giants would have an all-out battle to determine the fate of the next world. It was called the Battle of Ragnarok.
You wanna have a showdown?
Find us tomorrow night for one final confrontation.
They want us to meet them tomorrow night for one final confrontation.
Well, it's gotta be a trap.
Of course it's a trap. It all makes perfect sense now. They'll be waiting for us in Tetra's dream. Once we all show up, the Griffins will leave. And Tetra will use her medallion to wake herself up.
It's a good idea.
It's brilliant.
Flawless. Our minds would have all been nullified. We would have all woken up forfeit. I might have even woken up from my coma.
We can't go then.
No. We'll go, but only half of us. Zephyr will want to wait until we're all there to make his move. We'll hold them off until I can get the medallion. When I have it, then the rest of our forces will come in. They won't dare dream jump back to their base because of that close of range we can follow them. They'll be forced to stay and fight, and we outnumber them 2-1.
It'll be a slaughter.
Brilliant, Zephyr, but I've second-guessed you again. Assemble the troops. Tomorrow we make our final counter-move. I know Norse legend, Zephyr. It would appear better than you. You've overlooked one minor detail. At the Battle of Ragnarok, evil was to triumph.
So, where's Tetra? Good question.
I'm up here, guys.
So what is this place, Tetra?
Well, it looks like my school.
You dream about your school?
Not on purpose.
At least you know the terrain. So where would a good defensive position be?
Right down here.
Okay, guys, I'm gonna set up tactical down here. You and you go find sniper positions. Brent, take Tetra to a safe place. You got it, boss.
This way.
Wait.
What?
It's a perfect bottleneck position. First dragon you see, beat him around here. I'll be hiding in the tree.
Got it.
Okay, this is fine.
Yeah, I suppose this is as good a spot as any. Get down. So, nervous?
Yeah.
Don't worry. I'll make sure nothing happens to you.
All right, Wing Dragon, here we go.
Everybody, up those steps.
All right, guys, they're here, but there's only half of them. Nobody else shows in 5 minutes, we'll take what we've got.
Be ready up here. When I give you the signal, cover me. I'm going to get the angle.
It's all right. It's all right.
All right, Tetra. Now we'll see what your worst nightmare is. A demon. Very well.
What was that?
I don't know.
All right, stay here. I got this.
Son of a... Yeah, this time I'm not going to send you back to your leader. I'm going to finish you off myself.
My leader's going to be very disappointed. Yeah! It ends here, pal.
What? No.
Book takes bishop. Good night.
Say cheese.
didn't see a smile.
Vanessa, you're on tactical.
Wait, where are you going?
I'm going to pull Zephyr's chest piece out of his dead
hand. Come on, we've got to get that medallion.
Sorry.
It's not your fault. Come on. Jump up and get me, all right?
Got it.
Go.
Wind Dragon!
I've been waiting for blood all night.
Where the hell did that come from?
All right, Chucks, don't fail me now.
I've waited a long time for this honor, Wind Dragon. It's about time.
Looks like King takes Rourke.
Are you ready to dance? The dance of death.
But whose death will it be, Zephyr? I know what you fear most, Zephyr, and I don't even have to change. Over one constant in dreams.
What's that, Wind Dragon?
I'm better than you. My spear has found the hearts of three other Griffin kings, Zephyr. What makes you think you are?
You bet your wit's not as sharp as your spear.
Made it out.
Yep, we all made it.
Clyde and Amy woke up, but we all made it. Kyle gave us the signal as soon as you got the medallion.
I was worried you wouldn't make it out in time. But wait a minute. What about...
Dragons? Not a one. All gone. Whiteboard clean.
We did it.
You did it, Tetra. You won this war for us.
Does this mean the game's over?
For a while. The Silver Side will instate a new king, and they'll start selecting new players. But they won't become anything to worry about for a while.
We have plenty of time then.
We sure do. Time enough to get to know one another.
Well, for once, I think I'm going to take a walk. A nice, relaxing walk. Oh, and guys, pleasant dreams.